Finally, a tripod and gimbal headset designed specifically for wildlife photographers. I'm going to take this kit out from Sirui and test it whilst I aim to get portraits of red deer before the rutting season really gets underway. So let's crack on. So, I'm going to take you through the features of this tripod. But firstly, let's talk about the case. Because often with tripods, I find that the cases aren't that useful because they're just really a carrying bag. But this is a proper case. It's well padded and it's sturdy. And that is ideal for any photographer who travels, particularly if you're going on flights. You could put this case into the hold and you would have no worries about it getting damaged. But also for people who travel in cars, I often put my tripod on the back seat because I don't want it bouncing around if I go over a hump or a bump in the road and then smashing down on my camera gear. But I would have no worries with this because it's a good padded case. So let's take a look inside. So here we can see the tripod and all the parts that come with it and that thick padded case. But the tripod itself is really, really lightweight, and that's because the legs are made entirely of carbon fibre. So I can hold it there really easily, just a couple of fingers, and there's no worries. So with this strapped to your camera back, it won't be a problem for you to carry it around. But the legs are also patterned as camouflage, so that is really useful for wildlife photographers because we often find with tripods that there are bright colours on them, and that can be very distracting for the subjects that we're trying to photograph. The other parts of the tripod are made of aluminium, so such as these ratchets here and the knobs that you turn to extend the legs. But more importantly, they are coloured matte green. So that means they're not going to be reflecting a lot of light and they won't distract your subjects. We have to remember that much of the wildlife world sees light a little bit differently to humans. And bright light, particularly things that are reflecting from shiny metal objects, can be really distracting for your subject and make it apparent that you're there. So what else do you get? Well, there's also a gimbal head, and the gimbal head's main body is also carbon fibre, and the metal parts of it are also matte green, so made just to the same design as the tripod itself. And this is really, really sturdy. So I'll talk about the gimbal a little bit more shortly. But you also get with it a base plate that's Arca Swiss compatible with the gimbal head. And this may be better than the base plate or the foot that you have on your lens already because, again, this is matte green. We also get inside here a set of Allen keys or hex keys and a set of spikes. And these are really heavy duty spikes. So these spikes will be useful if you're photographing on soft ground because you can replace the rubber feet on the end of the tripod and wedge these spikes into the ground to hold your tripod steady. And then finally, there's another plate, which I'll elaborate on in a moment because you can change some things around with that gimbal head. So one of the interesting features about this tripod is the leveling base at the top of it. And this allows you to work however you prefer. Now, there are two prevailing trails of thought when it comes to how to level a tripod. There are some people that like to get the legs straight, so that the base that you put the head upon is straight. And there are some people that say, just put the legs out and then use the leveling base to get it level. And you can work either way. So if you like to get the legs straight, you have the pins on the leveling base stuck out and you simply drop them into the slots there and then use the knob underneath to tighten it up and hold it firm. But if you're a person who likes to make sure the leveling base is flat and then mount your head on top of that, you simply Take the leveling base and twist the blue knobs underneath it, and it retracts those pins. And then within the bowl, you can set the leveling base to whatever you want. And again, just use the knob to tighten it up. So let me show you here. If I get this leveling bowl level, there we are, and I just screw in the knob underneath. So there you can see the leveling base is now perfectly level, so I can mount the gimbal head on top of that without any worries that even though the legs aren't level, it's going to unbalance the gimbal head. So that gives you real flexibility to use this tripod however you prefer to work. So a couple of other nice features about this tripod are that it's got a couple of external screw mounts that allow you to mount accessories to the tripod. There's one just here and one here of different thread sizes, and they allow you to attach things like a video monitor or an external battery pack or some audio recording equipment, and you can mount those directly to the tripod. So this gimbal head just screws on to the leveling plate as so. And I have to say that the gimbal head feels really nice to use. The knobs turn very smoothly, allowing you to both pan and to tilt without any real resistance. So that's great to make sure that we get those action shots. So here's the camera mounted on the gimbal head. And I would say this is a traditional gimbal head, a kind of gimbal head that's got an L arm on it. And that allows you to have that really smooth motion. But there is another type of gimbal head that's really popular with wildlife photographers, and that is the side-mounted gimbal head. Now, this setup is actually both. Remember that other plate I mentioned to you earlier? Well, this allows you to unscrew the L arm, and you can replace it with this plate to turn it into a side-mounted gimbal head. So I'll show you that now. So that is now a perfectly balanced side-mounted gimbal head. And I can use it just the same as I would in the other orientation. I point it there, the camera stays there. I point it there, the camera stays there. It works absolutely brilliantly. And just like the tripod, gives you the ultimate flexibility to work in the way that you want to. So who is this tripod and gimbal head set for? Well, it's really for anybody who's seriously into their wildlife photography. It's absolutely fantastic that a tripod manufacturer like Sirui has thought about the wildlife photographer and created a product specifically for us that answers a lot of our needs and allows us to work in a really flexible way. And because it's quite a specialized bit of kit, you can't just go online and buy it. You won't find it if you search for it on Google. And you won't find it if you go to the Sirui website even. You need to go to your local camera shop, a Sirui dealer, and order it through them. It retails for $799, but it is a worthwhile investment for anyone who I would say is at that advanced amateur through to pro level and is really interested in a bit of kit that's going to work well for them and last them a long time. So I've thoroughly enjoyed using this kit, designed specifically for wildlife photographers. Who'd have thought of that? And so you will see me using this tripod and gimbal head a lot in the future if you're a regular subscriber to my YouTube channel. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.